In the previous video, we had done two problems on simply supported beam, one having only point loads and the other one having only UDL. Now we will take up the third problem on simply supported beam only, having both UDL and as well as the point loads. Here the problem number 18 I have selected from the question bank. A simply supported beam of 8 meter length, it is simply supported, means there is one support this side, one support that side. This is the left support, that is the right support. Carries two point loads of 30 and 40 kilonewton at distances of 1.5 meter and 6.5 meter from the left supports respectively. So 1.5 meter from the left support, it has one point load. From left support at a distance of 6.5 meters, it has got one more point load. They are 30 kilonewtons and 40 kilonewton. This is 30 and that is 40. And it also carries a UDL of 10 kilonewton per meter between the point loads. That means from here to here, that is this distance becomes 5 meters, because this is 1.5, this is 6.5. The difference between 6.5 and 1.5 is 5. So this is 5, and again this will be 1.5 meters. Next step, what we have to do is redraw this beam again, converting this UDL into a point load. I can convert it into one point load because there is no load in between these two points. No point load is there. Suppose there was a point load here, then this much is to be separately done and this much is to be separately done. We have to divide it into two point loads. Because there is no point load in between these two points, I can put this entire thing as one point load. So it will be 5 meters. From here to here it is 5 meters. Per meter it is 10 kilonewtons. So for 5 meters, 5 into 10, that becomes 50 kilonewton. It will be placed exactly in between these two points. That is 2.5 meters from this point to this point and 2.5 meters from that point to that point. Do you understand that? Do you follow it? Now, after we have done this, we have to first calculate these two reactions. We have to calculate RA and RE. To calculate RA and RE, there are totally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 forces acting here. Out of 4, 5, you know, 3, these two we do not know. So they have to be found out. So for that, what I have done is, I have marked these as A, B, C, D, E. So this is RA and that is RE. Now what I do is, sum of upward forces, same technique is to be followed in any simply supported beam. First thing that you have to find out is the two reactions, this left reaction and the right reaction. For that, what we have to do is, for the beam to be in equilibrium, first point is the sum of upward forces must be equal to sum of downward forces. And the second point is, if you take moments at A or E, the sum of clockwise moments must be equal to the sum of anti-clockwise moments. This is the theory. So applying that, upward forces, sum of upward forces is RA plus RD, RE, sorry. RA plus RE must be equal to 30 plus 50 plus 40. 30 plus 50 plus 40, that works out to 120 kilonewton. The sum of these two upward forces must be equal to the sum of the downward forces. These are the downward forces. If you add them, you will get that much. Then taking moments of all forces at A, sum of anti-clockwise moments must be equal to clockwise moments. This is only one anti-clockwise moments. These are all clockwise moments. These are all clockwise. They come on one side. Anti-clockwise moments will come on one side. So anti-clockwise moments are E into this distance from here to here, that is 8 meters, is equal to this force multiplied by this, that is 40 into this is 6.5, 5 plus 1.5, 6.5 plus 50 into 4 plus 30 into 1.5. I hope you are understanding that. So this will be 8RE is equal to, take the calculator, 40 into 6.5. 40 into 6.5 plus 50 into 4 plus 30 into 1.5. It gives me 505. So RE will be equal to 505 divided by this 8. Answer divided by 8 will give me 63.125 kilonewton. This is RE. RE is 63.125 kilonewton. Then RA. RA will be, the total of RA and RE is 120. So 120 minus this 63.125. This will give me, 120 minus answer will give me 56.875 kilonewton. 56.875 kilonewton. That is RA and that is RE. Next, after that, what I have to do is, I have to do SF and BM calculations as usual, as we have been doing already. SF at E, from that side we come. SF calculations. First, SF at E will be plus, because it is upward, 63.125 kilonewton. Right. Now, next, SF at D will be plus 63.125 minus 40. That is 23 plus 23.125 kilonewton. Then SF at C. At C, you have come to this place. So, plus 63, that is already there. Plus 23.125, this is there. Minus 50. 23.125. Minus 50 gives me minus 26.875 kilonewton. Then SF at B will be minus 26.875 minus 30, that is minus 56.875 kilonewton. Then SF at A, you come to the end, minus 56.875 plus 56.875, that is 0 kilonewton. If you get 0, that means it is the problem we have done correctly. So this is the SF calculation. Then drawing we must do as we have done here. Here it will be vertical lines. Here it will be an inclined line, because that is a uniformly distributed load. Then after this, we have to do BM calculation. BM calculations will be, again, BM at E. At E, plus 63.125. into 0, that is 0. Always that last end will be 0. BM at D. Now we have come to D. Next point. There it will be plus 63.125 into 1.5. We have moved 1.5 meters. Minus 40 into 0. that will be 63.125 into 1.5. That works out to 94.6875. You can take it as 7 kilonewton meter. BM at C. Now one more force will come. Plus 63.125. This will be carried into how much I have moved? I have moved 2.5 meters further. So it will be 4 meters. 1.5 plus this thing. Minus 40 into this distance from here to here, it is 2.5 plus minus 50 into 0. 50 into 0, that will be 63.125 into 4 minus 40 into 2.5. That will give us 152.5 kilonewton meter. Then BM at, we come to B, that is I have come here at B, plus 63.125 into 6.5, another 2.5 meters, minus 40 into 5 minus 50 into 2.5 minus 30 into 0. All the forces to the right up to that point. Next, plus 63.125 into 6.5 minus 40 into 5 minus 50 into 2.5 minus 30 into 0, that will be 0, to 85.3125. Can leave it as 85.3 kilonewton meters. Then BM at A will be, I have come to the last point, it must come 0, plus 63.125, another 1.5 meters I have moved, so into 8, minus 40 into 6.5, right, 6.5, minus 50 into 4, minus 30 into 1.5 plus 56.875 into 0. This I must get as 0. That's a check. 63.125 into 8 minus 40 into 6.5 minus 50 into 4 minus 30 into 1.5 minus, that is 0, equals 0. I am getting the answer as 0, that is correct. 0 kilonewton per meter. Then leave some space here, draw the SF diagram and the BM diagram. Now, I'll roughly draw that. Here, first, we will draw the SF diagram, leave some space here. This is the zero line, plus 63.125. Here, up to here, it will come like this, then it will fall down like this, 40. So, remaining is 23.125. Up to here it will be same, then it will be minus 26, it will fall 50 here, so minus 26 point something, then it will come up to here, it will be minus 56 point something, then it will come like this. So it will be like this. Here, this is a point load, this is vertical, this is horizontal, this is not a, this is a point load, this is not a point load. So from here to here, it is not a point load. So it will come like this. It will come like this. This is a point load. This is a point load. This is how it will come. This is the figure. This is the figure that we get. This is the figure that we get. This is the SFD. Now, BMD will be, for BMD, leave some space down and draw this zero line. So there it is zero. Here it is 94 point something. Then 152 point something. Here it is 85 point something. Again zero here. So this will be a curve like this. This will be, because that is UDL. Here it will be a straight line. Here also it will be a straight line. It will come like this. This is how the BMD will come. So these figures you will have to draw. Mark these values there. These values are to be marked. Here it is 152.5. Here it is 94.7. Approximately. This is 85.3. We'll mark those values and leave it like that. So this is how it is to be done. This finishes that problem. If you have any doubts, you can always ask me. You please subscribe and get these problems.